Hello and welcome to Keys to the Crown, presented by Crown Royal. I'm Erin Summers, joined by Marcas Grant, NFL Network's fantasy football expert. Now, Marcas, as a Saints fan, it has been a bit of a roller coaster of emotions for me, and I assume it's probably the same for a lot of fantasy football owners who have any of our players on their team, especially running back Alvin Kamara. He did not have any targets for the first time in his NFL career in Sunday's game. Is this a trend or something we should be worried about?
I don't think so. I think it was a weird thing, and it's definitely something to pay attention to. And trust me, anybody who has Alvin Kamara definitely paid attention to it. But I think because this offense has had its ups and downs, I think at some point they understand they need to get Kamara the football as a pass catcher in order for them to be successful. So I think it was a thing that happened. I think Sean Payton and the offense is going to look at what happened, and I don't think we're going to see a repeat of this too many more times.
Anybody at this point in the season that's really stood out to you? Anybody you're buying at this point?
I think one guy that I am in the same division is Sam Darnold, who, believe it or not, entering week five, leads the NFL in rushing touchdowns. He's got five of them. That's something that nobody ever would have imagined. And I don't know if it's the combination of just getting away from the Jets and his former head coach, Adam Gase. I don't know if it's being in Carolina and having a ton of weapons around him. It's probably a combination of all those things. But Sam Darnold has looked absolutely great through the first 4 weeks of the season. And I think that's going to continue, actually, for the foreseeable future. The schedule is generally pretty friendly for the Panthers, and I think Darnold can continue to be very productive.
Kind of on the other side of that, anybody at this point, we're four games in, anybody that you're just not happy with, that you're wanting off of your team, suggesting that you find somebody else for?
Well, I will stay in Carolina, right? For as good as Sam Darnold has been, Robbie Anderson has been that much of a disappointment. And it was surprising because a lot of us believed that they would have a connection since they played together with the Jets. It just seemed like a really natural fit. Instead, it has very much been the DJ Moore show down there in Carolina. And so it's made it really hard to start Robbie Anderson. And now at this point, you're wondering, do you even keep him on your roster? Because he's just not getting enough opportunities in that Panther pass game. So that was a disappointment. I really drafted him sort of in the middle round, expecting a whole lot of big plays and touchdowns, and really we've gotten none of that so far.
Staying in the division again, we're going to talk about Atlanta Falcons running back Cordarrelle Patterson, the Flash. He had an amazing game, 82 yards, three touchdowns. Definitely one of the better picks anybody could have had in their fantasy lineup last Sunday. Who do you think is going to be somebody that's going to have a big week here in week five?
I think one of the guys you want to keep an eye out for is Damian Williams. Now he's the lead running back for the Chicago Bears after the injury to David Montgomery. And it looks like Montgomery's going to be out for a number of weeks. Let's not forget, it's not that long ago that Damian Williams was playing in the Super Bowl for the Kansas City Chiefs and had a really big game in that win against the San Francisco 49ers. So now he steps into a situation where he's going to get a lot of work, a lot of carries, a lot of targets out of the backfield. And it starts with a pretty good matchup this week against the Las Vegas Raiders, who had a tough time with Austin Eckler on Monday Night Football. So I look for the expanded opportunity for Damian Williams to really translate into something. And I imagine he will be a very popular name off the waiver wire, especially for folks who have lost Montgomery for the next month or so.
Absolutely. All right, we're going to tie this up with a bow, go back to the Saints in their game this coming Sunday against Washington. They will be in D.C. for that game. Who are we starting? Who are we sitting? And who is going to be a sleeper in that one?
Well, I'm going to tell people to start Alvin Kamara just sort of as a reassurance, right? After what happened this past week, just remind everybody that, Alvin Kamara is still very good at football. The Saints are going to use him heavily, so don't panic too much about what happened last week. You're sitting the Washington defense, which at the start of the year, I think we all felt like they were going to continue to be great because they were great last year. But through the first month of the year, people have been picking on them. So I'm not as confident in starting them, even with the Saints having their ups and downs off. Offensively, I wouldn't rush to go start the Washington defense this week because they just had a lot of problems. But I do think a sleeper is Taylor Heinicke, the quarterback for the Washington football team, who's played very well the last couple of weeks after he took over for Ryan Fitzpatrick. And whether it's with his arm or with his legs, however he's doing it, he's been getting you 20 plus fantasy points each and every week. So I would continue for that to roll, especially if you have a quarterback, say, like Teddy Bridgewater, who's in concussion protocol, any of these guys who maybe are out or not playing particularly well, Taylor Heinicke could be a nice sleeper substitute.
Hey, I like the pick of sitting the Washington defense because that means that the Saints offense has an opportunity to do some good things on Sunday. Thank you so much for the insight, Marcas. We really appreciate it. I'm Erin Summers. This has been Keys to the Crown presented by Crown Royal.